September 11th, 2001 is a day in history that no one will or can ever forget. Being alive during the most prominent terrorist attack in American history, and the fact that my father was an eyewitness to the event, compelled me to learn more about his experience and what he had learned from the event.
Normally, in my job with Yellow Book USA, which is a Yellow Page company, I would have a Monday morning sales meeting. And the sales meeting would be at One Penn Plaza, which is about 3 miles north of the World Trade Center at the time. Okay. What happened was we were at a sales meeting that Monday out on Long Island, and we were told that we would have our normal sales meeting on Tuesday morning, September 11th, at One Penn Plaza, and we would all convene at 8:30 in the morning on the 20th floor, which is where our offices were. Now, One Penn Plaza, the 20th floor, the Yellow Book offices, was an office that you were able to see kind of a panoramic view of New York City. You were able to see the Empire State Building. You were able to see the World Trade Center, the Statue of Liberty. There were no partitions. It was all an open view, and there were windows all around. Well, when the first plane hit, we weren't even aware of it. We were in the middle of our meeting, and some people that were in our office normally that came in late for the meeting ended up putting their hands over their mouths, and they pointed out the window, and they pointed, and whoever saw that turns around, and we looked out the window, and we saw, in a distance, that there was smoke coming out of the first World Trade Center tower, and we all had assumed at that point that it was an accident, it was an explosion. The day was crystal clear, so we didn't think that and a plane hit it. It would have been impossible at that point that a plane would hit it. But at that point, we had no idea that it was any sort of a terrorist act.
Though there were many targets for attacks by Al-Qaeda, the most fatal were the ones at the World Trade Center in New York City. 3,000 people perished in New York alone, as well as thousands of others injured. At the time, people thought it was merely an accident. Later would they find that Osama bin Laden was the culprit.
We're told by our managers at that point that because of what we saw at the window, we took from our meeting, and we were told to contact, if we had any relatives or whatever, or friends that lived or worked down in that area, to give them a call to make sure they were okay. We still thought that it was some sort of an accident, and what happened was that right around 9 o'clock, we were told that our meeting would then start again. And as the meeting was progressing, I and a lot of other people there kind of had one eye focused on the meeting, and we had one eye focused out the window looking at what was going on down at the World Trade Center. I'll never forget that I saw that second plane was flying around, and it looked very small. Even though it was a 767 aircraft, it looked like a very small plane within the dimensions of the World Trade Center. And I saw the plane go very low, and it was making kind of its turn. And my thought was, what is that plane doing down there? Is it taking pictures? Why would it be flying so low? And then as the plane, I lost sight of the plane going around the back end of the World Trade Center. All of a sudden, I saw upon impact that there was a tremendous fireball that came out when the plane hit the second tower. And there were a number of people that were looking at it at the same time, and there was a scream kind of, a number of people screamed at the same time when that second plane hit. And we all knew at that point that this was not an accident, that this was something far worse. And at that point, we had ended the meeting immediately and told by our managers to evacuate our offices because essentially we were under attack.
Fare thee well, my own true love. Farewell for a while. I'm going.
So I took a different route. I walked down 7th Avenue toward Grand Central, and I ended up cutting up either 37th or maybe 39th Street to 5th Avenue. And when I was, you know, walking quickly toward Grand Central at that point, I'll never forget, first of all, hearing the fire engines all rushing toward the World Trade Center. And in retrospect, I said, you know, I wonder how many of these firemen actually survived. So many of them perished. And the other thing was, I ended up just seeing people on Fifth Avenue looking at the World Trade Center and just kind of, you know, pointing and talking while I was rushing toward Grand Central.
The rocks made.
I know that there were a few people that were parents or relatives of classmates of two of my children that were there, but personally, I really didn't know anybody that was killed. But you really didn't have to know anybody personally. It affected New York. It affected this country in a way that I'll never forget.
It appears that there is more and more fire and smoke enveloping the very top of the building, and as fire crews are descending on this area. It does not appear that there's any kind of an effort up there yet. Now remember, oh my God.
Oh my God.
That looks like a second plane.
I didn't see a plane go in. That just exploded.
We just saw another plane coming in from the side.
You did. That was out of up.
Yes, and that's
you.
The second explosion. You could see the plane come in just from the right-hand side of the screen. So this looks like it is some sort of a concerted effort to attack the World Trade Center that is underway in downtown New York.
And there you can see the situation.
Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen.
One of the things that became very apparent that I knew before but became strengthened afterward is that you have to fight to protect your freedom. One of the things that I think our country did very well the advent of the World Trade Center attacks is that we realized that you need to take steps to protect yourself, and you have to take a proactive stance on making sure that you protect yourself and you stay safe.
The nation and the world learned a valuable lesson that day. If anything, we've learned to be more cautious, increase national security, and be aware of possible threats posed on our country. But these are all afterthoughts. I guess the biggest lesson that anyone can learn is that within an instant, the world can catch fire, and only we can prevent it from ever happening.